Welcome to another episode of the Confident Fit Woman podcast, the number one podcast for women who want to lose weight in a sustainable and non-restrictive way. And today, we're going to talk about women weight loss, common challenges and common struggles that a lot of women go through, because it can be a very complex and unique journey for everybody, but it has different various factors, you know, hormonal fluctuations, psychological, lifestyle, all that good stuff. So I want to talk all about it today. And for those of you that are super overwhelmed with your health and fitness journey, you don't know what you need to do, you're like, oh my God, I am stressed out. What you need to do is that you need to comment me below, because I have created a free Facebook community that's gonna help you get to your goals step by step, and I'm gonna teach you exactly what you need to do. So drop me below this video or send me a message on my Instagram and I'll send you the link for the group, oh my God, into your DMs without any logins or anything like that. So my gift to you for listening to me ramble on forever. And for those of you that are listening and watching me for the first time, my name is Salome Abugur. Over the last 4 years, I have helped over 200 women lose 27 pounds of fat in the first 90 days with my program called The Dangerous Divas. And in every single video that you see, every podcast episode, my entire goal is to teach you guys everything you need to know to succeed forever. So today, we're gonna talk about our overall health, our emotional, and all that good stuff, because I think a lot of women are stressed out with all the challenges that come at us. So let's get started. I'm gonna get a sip of water because I am super dehydrated right now for whatever reason. I'm already at a gallon of water and I'm dehydrated. Go figure out. All right, so understanding and addressing these challenges for a woman is crucial for achieving a sustainable and healthy weight loss journey. So we want to explore the common challenges that a lot of women face when it comes to weight loss. And then what I want to do is I want to provide you with some practical strategies to overcome them while prioritizing your overall health and well-being. Okay, so the first challenge that a lot of women go through is hormonal fluctuations. Am I right? I mean, come on, you know what I'm talking about. Women experience hormonal fluctuations through their menstrual cycle, pregnancy, premenopause, menopause, and it really makes a big difference in your weight loss journey. Okay, so during certain phases, such as the premenopausal phase or premenstrual phase, even cravings and water retention, sorry, I can't talk today, may increase. And as well, on top of that, hormonal changes can affect your energy levels and your metabolism. So what we need to do is that the first thing we need to do is that we need to track our menstrual cycle and we need to adjust our nutrition and exercise accordingly, okay, to carve the cravings away and make them a part of our lifestyle, as well as engaging in the stress reducing activities. Okay, also what we need to do on top of it is that we need to consult a healthcare specialist to explore their hormonal imbalances and then kind of see what you can do that's holistic, that's going to help you with that. They're going to give you some guidance and, you know, appropriate things, and if you don't want to do that, don't do that. Okay, the second challenge that women go through all the time is metabolic differences, right? Women generally, in general, have a way lower resting metabolic rate compared to men, okay? And that's due to body composition, muscle mass, hormonal profiles, all that good stuff. Have you guys ever met a man that has lost like 10 pounds in a week and you're like, oh my God, how'd you do that? I can't do that. Yeah, because you're a woman and our metabolic rate is a lot lower. Sorry. It's the truth though. That means that women burn fewer calories at rest than men do, which makes it even more impossible. So what do we need to do to overcome this challenge? Because, you know, we're like, we can overcome anything, okay? We got this. So what we need to do is that we need to incorporate strength training exercises to be able to build that muscle and increase your metabolic rate, okay? And then on top of it, we need to focus on body composition and health improvements rather than just the number on the scale. A lot of people only focus on the number of the scale for their results. No, all right, weight loss might be slower, but your body composition is way more important, and it's going to lead to your improved strength, energy levels, and you're just going to feel so much healthier and better. All right, so stop relying on the scale, please. And then the third common most challenge that a lot of women go through is emotional and stress eating related. Stress-related eating. I'm telling you, I can't talk today. Women are way more prone to emotional eating and using food as a mechanism during the times of stress, which can obviously hinder your weight loss journey. So what we need to do is that we need to develop triggers for knowing what's going to happen and what is triggering our emotional eating, okay? Practicing mindfulness, breathing exercises, all that good stuff. All right, so we need to really figure out what's going on in our life that's making us do this, okay? And then the fourth, yes, I got a fourth one. The fourth most common challenge that a lot of women go through is societal pressures and body image. Like, society puts a lot of pressure on us, and there's a lot of unrealistic beauty standards that really impact our women's perception of what a woman should look like and our weight loss journey. But it's so important that you prioritize self-care and you prioritize yourself. Support yourself, you know, focus on your self-care, be self-compassionate, know that you are who you are and nobody can be you, right? And then surround yourself with people that are like, heck yes, girl, you got this, rather than comparing yourself to other people, okay? Stop with the self-comparison. There's a lot of things on social media that you see that are not real, all right? So shift your focus from overall health and well-being, from weight loss to overall health and well-being, because that's way more important. Prioritizing our health and our body to be able to live longer, be more confident, fit in our clothes, all that good stuff. We don't want to always feel like, you know, we're chasing the next pound to lose, you know? You want to do this in the right, sustainable way. So those are the four things that a lot of women go through, challenges, and hopefully the strategies that I've given you are helpful and give you a little bit of a different outlook to see through things. So yeah, I know that weight loss, you know, everybody has different ways of approaching it, but I like the holistic approach that addresses, you know, the hormonal fluctuations, the metabolic differences, the emotional eating, society pressures. It's still possible for you to achieve your weight loss goals, because I know you can do it. It's just, how are you gonna do it, right? Are you gonna be consistent enough? Are you gonna eat the right amount of food? Are you gonna be able to do your workout and have that schedule up as part of your, you know, routine? That's what's the most important. Remember that their journey and your weight loss journey is your journey, nobody else's. Your journey and your worth extends way beyond your weight and your appearance. So I want you to prioritize that self-care, self-acceptance, stop comparing about yourself to other people, because guess what? They are not you, all right? So what you need to do is that you need to transform that mindset into a positive mindset that's gonna help you get to your goals no matter what challenge is coming at you, okay? You guys are the freaking bomb. I appreciate you all so much, and I hope this helped you, you know, a little bit more into knowing that you are on the right track and you're gonna absolutely crush it. And I know how it is to start a fitness journey and being overwhelmed. So what I have done is I have created a free Facebook community with all the amazing ladies that are in there. And if I'm gonna teach you exactly what to do in order for you to get to your goals. So if you want in, drop me below this video or send me a message on my Instagram at Salome Abger, and I'll send you the link to the group so you can join us. My gift to you for listening to me ramble on. I love you all. I appreciate you all. I hope you have the best day ever, and I'll talk to you guys soon. Peace.